Welcome back guys to another space news video. In this video we will see about Ingenuity's upcoming flight test, SN11 and SN15 update, new spaceship 3 and many more. This is Light at Sky. Let's get started after the intro. At number 5, we have the NASA's Ingenuity helicopter. Ingenuity is a solar-powered helicopter which took 7 years to design, test and build. Perseverance rover carried this helicopter to Mars and the first scheduled flight was expected to take place on 8th April, but there is a change of plan and now the takeoff will take place on 11th April, as announced by the JPL. This will mark the first aircraft to attempt controlled flight on another planet. The Perseverance rover dropped a debris shield on March 21 that protected Ingenuity during landing and made its way to the airfield, where the helicopter will attempt its flight. The rover has released the helicopter on the Martian surface as of now. So what are the challenges and why is it so difficult to fly a helicopter on Mars? The reason is that Mars has approximately one-third that of Earth's gravity. The air quality and overall atmosphere is far less dense than our Earth's, leading to making flying on Mars more difficult. Also, Mars is about 244 million kilometers away from the Sun, almost about 94 million kilometers away from the Earth. Hence, it receives only about half of the amount of solar energy that reaches Earth during the daytime. Temperature can drop to minus 100 degrees Celsius, which could damage the electrical components of the helicopter. It has to autonomously keep itself warm and charge itself with the solar panels. The Perseverance rover will assist in communications related to the helicopter's commissioning and flight test campaign back and forth from the Earth. So currently, on 4th April, the helicopter was gently released and dropped from the rover on the surface of the Mars on the airfield. A photograph accompanying the tweet showed Perseverance had driven clear of the helicopter and its airfield after dropping to the surface. Ingenuity had been feeding off the Perseverance power system but will now have to use its own battery and also run a vital heater to protect its unshielded electrical components from freezing and cracking during the bitter Martian night. Ingenuity will open new possibilities and will spark questions for the future about what we could accomplish with an aerial explorer. At number 4, we have the Starship SN11 failed at landing. Another landing failure for SpaceX, as their Starship prototype failed to land safely on 30th March. Due to fog, the flight of the SN11 was not visible. However, the rocket reached the 10 km mark and also started its landing procedure. After 6 minutes, the broadcast cameras cut out. Elon Musk tweeted that something appeared to go wrong with one of the Raptor engines, but that may not be why the rocket crashed. Looks like engine 2 had issues on ascent and did not reach the operating chamber pressure during the landing burn. But in theory, it wasn't needed. Musk also wrote that something significant happened shortly after the landing burn start. Debris from the spacecraft was found scattered 8 km away from its landing site. The foggy conditions made difficult to witness the crash and point out the real reason. After a few days, the reason for the crash came from Elon himself in a tweet which said that ascent phase, transition to horizontal and control during free fall were all good. A small CH4 leak led to fire on engine 2 and fried parts of avionics, causing hard start attempting landing burn in CH4 turbopump. This is getting fixed, Musk tweeted. CH4 is methane, the propellant for SpaceX's most powerful next generation Raptor engine. And a hard start refers to ignition when there's too much fuel in the combustion chamber and the pressure is therefore too high. Not a good thing for any engine. SN8, 9 and 11, all three crash landed. SN10 landed but it too exploded after 8 minutes of landing. The next Starship prototype test of SN15 will be conducted soon. Fingers crossed, let's hope SN15 is successful. But the question arises, why serial number 12, that is SN12, is not the next Starship? The answer is that SN12 was never assembled, as SpaceX expects the SN15 to mark a significant technological leap on its predecessors. In a sense, the missing 3 rockets were scrapped to make way for the better and more robust designs. Individual segments of Starship SN16, 17 and 18 are also in works. However, Mr. Musk teased that Starship SN20 will mark the next big Starship upgrade. SpaceX is building its Starship program at a rapid pace and such can change expected launch dates and times on short notices. Its launch facilities are also in middle of Boca Chica village and requires SpaceX to issue road closures and evacuate residents, all of which takes time to organize. At number 3, we have the Virgin Galactic Spaceship 3. Virgin Galactic unveiled a new space plane dubbed VSS Imagine on 30th March, the first Spaceship 3 addition to the company's growing fleet of suborbital vehicles. It is designed for quicker reuse than the Spaceship 2, which are set to start the space tourism in 2022. This chrome-colored vehicle is functionally same as the company's earlier Spaceship 2, also known as VSS Unity. But Spaceship 3 is designed in a modular fashion that will enable a quicker turnaround time for the reflights. As said by the company, it is designed in such a way that we can pull off a panel to get to an area that we might not have been able to get to in an easy fashion before with the Spaceship 2. The design changes suggest that the company is heading for a production-intensive operation. As they are nearing to their goal of flying a customer to space in the year 2022, VSS Imagine weighs slightly less than Spaceship 2 and with a different interior look. The lessons learned from the test flights of Spaceship 2 are being applied and modified to bring up the Imagine spacecraft. The VSS Imagine's first glide test is up next, and in which it will be dropped from mid-air from its carrier plane to guide back to land. This will happen soon in coming days at the company's Spaceport America facility in New Mexico. So, this is not the end of Spaceship 2. The company is preparing for test flight of VSS Unity, which we can expect to be conducted in the month of May. This test was earlier conducted in last December, but the mission was aborted in mid-flight, just as the ship ignited its engines after being released mid-air from its mothership, VMS-EV. The abort was caused by electromagnetic interference that led to reboot of flight computer. As VSS Imagine begins ground testing, manufacturing will progress on VSS Inspire, the second Spaceship 3 vehicle within the Virgin Galactic fleet. The introduction of the Spaceship 3 class of vehicles is an important milestone in Virgin Galactic's multi-year effort that targets flying 400 flights per year per spaceport. VSS Imagine and Inspire are stunning ships that will take our future astronauts on an incredible voyage to space, and their names reflect the aspirational nature of human spaceflight. At number 2, we have the OSIRIS-REx, a final close approach to the asteroid Bennu. NASA's OSIRIS-REx spacecraft, which was launched in September 2016, arrived at the 1,640-foot-wide Bennu in December 2018. It took measurements of the asteroid, and then the probe maneuvered to the asteroid's surface to collect samples on 20th October of last year. The probe will make one final approach to the asteroid before heading back to Earth. On April 7th, the spacecraft will pass 3.7 kilometers above the location on the asteroid Bennu called Nightingale, where in October, the spacecraft briefly touched down and collected as much as several hundred grams of material, now stored in the spacecraft. Immediately after the sample collection maneuver, the mission had no plans to return to the vicinity of Bennu. However, NASA decided to make a final pass over the touchdown site to see what changes the sampling made to the Nightingale region, like the creation of a crater. Shortly after the sample collection maneuver, images showed some material leaking out of the sampling head that caused the mission to accelerate efforts to store the sample collection unit in a capsule that will store it during the return trip back to Earth. The flyby of the Nightingale site will be the one last time OSIRIS-REx approaches Bennu. The spacecraft will begin its trip back to Earth on May 10th, arriving on September 24th, 2023. The capsule containing the samples will land in Utah desert. If you think why to collect asteroid samples, the answer is that asteroids are building blocks left over from planet formation epoch. So such analysis could reveal key insights about our solar system's very early days. At number 1, we have the Inspiration 4 mission crew announced. Inspiration 4 mission is a planned SpaceX Crew Dragon mission to low Earth orbit operated by SpaceX on behalf of Jared S. Ackman. This private venture purchased a SpaceX Dragon flight to low Earth orbit and also have finalized the crew for that mission, scheduled to launch on 15th September 2021. It's the world's first all-civilian mission to space, which will carry 4 people. The crew members were revealed who will accompany its sponsor, entrepreneur Jared S. Ackman. The 4 crew members, starting with the sponsor himself, is an American billionaire businessman and pilot. He is the founder and CEO of Shift for Payments, a payment processor. He would serve as the commander of Inspiration 4. Second is Sian Proctor, a scientist and educator who has participated in a number of terrestrial analog astronaut missions. She won the seat called Prosperity by establishing an online store through Isaacman's company Shift for Payments and submitting a video judged by an independent panel. Third, Chris Sembroski, a Lockheed Martin employee in Seattle area. He won the generosity seat by participating in a sweepstakes that raised money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Fourth is Haley, a physician assistant at St. Jude, who as a child was treated for bone cancer. At the age of 29, Haley would be the youngest American in space. The four will start training as a group immediately. That training includes time in Crew Dragon simulators, going through all aspects of the mission, as well as centrifuges to simulate the accelerations of launch and re-entry and other forms of stress testing. The spacecraft will remain in orbit for 3 days, flying in an orbit at the same inclination as of the International Space Station, that is around 51.6 degrees, but in an orbit as high as 540 kilometers, more than 100 kilometers above the station. This orbit will be the highest people have ever been above the Earth's surface since the final shuttle servicing mission to the Hubble Space Telescope in 2009. This mission will establish that we are ready to go to space, next reaching to Moon and then to Mars and beyond. The Inspiration 4 mission will use the same Dragon spacecraft called Resilience, currently docked at the ISS for Crew 1 mission. That spacecraft is currently scheduled to return to Earth on April 28, assuming the Crew 2 mission launches to the station on schedule on April 22. Besides refurbishing the spacecraft, SpaceX will install an additional window on the spacecraft, a viewing port modeled on the space station's cupola that will replace the docking adapter under the spacecraft's nose cone. Since the Inspiration 4 mission will not dock with the station, that adapter is not needed. Inspiration 4 will be the first Crew Dragon mission for a customer other than the NASA, but it is not the only one on its manifest. Axiom Space will fly 4 people to the ISS on its AX-1 mission in 2022. Space Adventures previously announced a Crew Dragon mission that would fly well above the station, but that space tourism company has not provided any updates on its schedule for that mission. Thank you for staying till the end. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share the video with your close ones. These were some of the interesting news of the last couple of weeks. That's the end of this video. Meet you guys in the next one. Until then, keep watching Lighted Sky. Enjoy and take care. Thank you. Don't forget to check out my other videos.